What's up, guys? John Rettinger here. One of the really cool things about the Lenovo S10 netbook is it actually ships with two operating systems on it. One, Windows XP, which is probably going to be your de facto operating system for most of your tasks, but it also has this really cool QuickOn OS, which is fantastic for wanting to check your email, viewing some pictures, or even getting on Skype. So let me go ahead and show you what that looks like, and we'll do a short walkthrough. Go ahead and turn it on. And you'll get the Lenovo splash screen in just a second. There it is. And pretty quickly after, you get this splash top OS. And that's really it. If you don't move the mouse at all, you'll go right into Windows XP. There won't be much of a delay. But if you want to check out the Quick Start OS, let me show you what we have here. Share Your Ideas, which is sort of a Lenovo version of a social network. And I'll show you everything here. You've got Skype, chat, photos, online games, music, and web. Now, what most people are going to use this for is probably the web, so let me show you what that looks like first. So again, Lenovo Quick Start, powered by Splashtop. And I believe this is a very, very, very simple Linux kernel that they installed on this. It'll take a second to load. Server not found. So it takes does take a little bit to connect to the wireless network. But it is actually a relatively full-featured operating system, which is pretty neat, and the browser is actually relatively good. So there it goes. And one of the cool things about this browser is you can do anything that you normally would do. So you can very easily view YouTube videos. I'll show you right here. YouTube.com. Go in, check your email, watch some of your favorite videos, you know, really whatever you want, and you're good to go. So here's a video on the Kentucky Derby. And there you go, you can start watching. Which is actually pretty cool. So let me go ahead and turn this off here. In the Kentucky Derby. So this is the browser. It's a great browser. You can do whatever you want. You can bookmark pages and check your email or, you know, really anything that you can do with the normal browser. Except for download files. I'm going to close that off. And here we are back at the Quick Start operating system. Now, when you close an application after the first time, you get this sort of Mac OS X-ish dock where you can power off the computer, exit, or go into all those applications we just saw before. So let's take a look at music. I'm going to kind of walk you guys through each one of these very briefly. And the dock will just go away if you move your mouse. And you've got just a very rudimentary music player. You can have some music stored on this partition. And that's it. You can access all the files in my computer or an external storage drive. So you can plug in a USB hard drive or thumb drive and get rocking on your music. So we will close out of here. Let's keep moving along and see what else we got. Next one, online games. Let's see what kind of games we have. And I gotta tell you guys, for when I'm just sitting on the couch and I want to check my email, I'm really using this QuickOn OS, really more than I'm using Windows XP, which is kind of neat. It just takes you to really different array of games that you can play. Sudoku, Bloom's Tower Defense, I'm using Santa Dress Up. You know, kind of a bunch of cool little games you can play when you're just sitting around. So we'll give this a close, and let's keep moving along on this QuickOn OS. Come on. There we go. Okay, so the next thing that we have, and there I just popped up my configuration panel where you can configure your network, the date and time, environment, screen settings, volume control, and launch bar settings. Next one is pictures, photos rather. Opened up the games again. There we go. Load photos. You can see that this can be a little bit on the squirrely side, but for the most part, it actually works very well. So initializing, you've got a nice simple photo viewer. You know, with the same interface you had for the music player, but you can view your photos and show them to people if you just want to turn your computer on and say, hey, take a look at a picture of my dog, you know, you can show it to whoever real quickly. So we'll close out of this. And we'll keep moving along. Now there is a chat client. If you want to hop on AIM and talk to a buddy, tell him to meet you at the movies or something. So welcome to chat. You just add your accounts, and it's really just a pretty full-featured chat application. Nothing terribly exciting, but you can get to it really quickly, which is nice. Next thing we have is Skype. And Skype, for those of you that may not know, is a voice over IP phone client, meaning you can make calls to a landline, to other Skype lines, really whatever, right through here. And it is actually very neat, and you can take advantage of the built-in webcam for Skype chat while you're using this. So we don't need to sign up for a Skype account, I just wanted to show you that it was there. And then you get share your ideas. And I'll show you what that looks like. Move the mouse, get rid of the dock. Really, it's just discover social media, all about Lenovo, Lenovo forums, Lenovo blogs, and really things about the company. So guys, overall, I really got to say, I'm pretty impressed with this QuickOn OS. It's relatively full-featured, it's pretty robust, it seems to be pretty stable as well. So definitely recommend it, and it's a nice added feature. A lot of netbooks are shipping with some sort of QuickOn OS, and this is Lenovo's take on it. Anyway guys, hope you enjoyed. For exclusive content, be sure to follow me on Twitter, twitter.com/John4Lakers. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.